After close to 18 years of Joseph Kony in hiding, the ICC has today announced its commitment to hear the 33 charges against the LRA leader in his absence.
What the prosecutor has decided during in mind that aspect and the fact that this prosecution or investigation, allow me to say, has taken so long to materialize, he has considered that it was appropriate and necessary to actually advance the proceeding against Kony, even in his absence, by requesting the judges for a confirmation of charge hearing in his absence.
The infamous Lord Resistance Army commander was in 2005 charged with 33 counts of war crimes and crimes against humanity that he allegedly committed across 3 decades in northern and northeastern Uganda, South Sudan, the Democratic Republic of Congo, and the Central African Republic.
Many of the victims in northern Uganda, as we've heard over the years, have felt abandoned in the sense that they consider they were not reflected in the case that was brought against Dominic Ongwen. So we hope that by addressing Joseph Kony criminal responsibility, there will be a way to also maximize, to the extent possible, the voices of the victims in northern Uganda.
The international cooperation advisor in the office of the prosecutor in the ICC, Dahiru Santana, today held a press conference in Gulu City to confirm that the court is breaking new grounds in ensuring that Joseph Kony is brought to justice and proceed with the confirmation of charges against the LRA rebel leader in his absence.
I would say it's a good news, because all we need for our people in northern Uganda is justice. However, the other aspect of it is the challenges associated with one, getting him.
Joseph Kony with his LRA rebels are suspected of murder, rape, and abduction of thousands of people, destroyed property, including the burning of houses, orchestrating massacre attacks in Lukodi, Balonyo, Atiak, and several other places in Uganda against a civilian population.
They have to do the truth telling. This is not like for the Ongwen, but this one, it is going to be community victims in the different region in northern Uganda, not on Acholi.
The Joseph Kony led LRA rebels also caused the displacement of over 1 million people in northern and northeastern Uganda. The victims want a speedy trial to serve as a deterrent to other rebel leaders.
What we wanted, it is justice. We don't want anyone again can come and pick a younger children. As all of us, we know, for so many years, the children of this country suffering because of Kony and the government of this country.
Komakech Henry Kilama is the victim's lead lawyer in the trial of another former LRA commander, Thomas Koyelo. He says the trial of Joseph Kony will help to establish and settle the demands of the people affected by the LRA war.
Victims want justice, they want the truth to be known, they want also some kind of conviction of the person who's charged or indicted for the crimes. And then three, just want reparations and some rehabilitation of their lives. Some people have lost limbs, some have lost property, some have lost loved ones. So all those, they want some kind of compensation for those losses.
Joseph Kony has been wanted by the International Criminal Court since 2005, when he was indicted alongside Vincent Otii, Ruskus Lukuyia, Odhiambo, and Dominic Ongwen, who has already been convicted to 25 years in prison. The Uganda Police Force is waiting to cooperate in order to serve justice.
What we hope to do with this procedure is to actually bring the Kony matter into the discussion, into the center of the attention of other states and international organizations.
We don't have any problem cooperating with them. So it's just a matter of giving us a guideline on what information they want from us as the police, and we shall be in position to give them the information which are authentic and at our discretion.
It is 18 years since the ICC indicted Joseph Kony and 4 others. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.